Page 114. Lesson 4. Telephone conversation. Vol Soinka.
The price seemed reasonable. Location indifferent. The landlady swore she lived off premises. Nothing remained but self-confession. Madam, I warned, I hate a wasted journey. I am African. Silence. Silenced transmission of pressurized good breeding. Voice when it came. Lipstick coated. Long. Gold rolled. Cigarette holder. Pipped. Caught I was foully. How dark. I had not misheard. Are you light or very dark? Button B, button A. Stench of rancid breath of public hide and speak red booth. Red pillar box. Red double-tiered omnibus squelching tar. It was real. Shamed by ill-mannered silence. Surrender pushed, dumbfounded, to beg simplification. Considerate she was, varying the emphasis. Are you dark or very light? Revelation came. You mean like plain or milk chocolate? Her assent was clinical, crushing in its light impersonality. Rapidly, wavelength adjusted. I chose West African sepia, and as afterthought, down in my passport. Silence for spectroscopic flight of fancy, till truthfulness changed her accent. Hard on the mouthpiece. What's that? Conceding. Don't know what that is. Like brunette. That's dark, isn't it?
Not altogether. Facially, I am brunette. But, madam, you should see the rest of me. Palm of my hand, soles of my feet are a peroxide blonde. Friction caused. Foolishly, madam, by sitting down has turned my bottom raven black. One moment, madam. Sensing her receiver rearing on the thunderclap about my ears. Madam, I pleaded, wouldn't you rather see for yourself?
Page 115. About the poet. Vol Soinka, born 1934, is a famous Nigerian poet and playwright. He was educated at the Government College in Ibadan, Nigeria, and later at Leeds University, England, where he took a degree in English. He taught in the London schools and also worked in the Royal Court Theatre. He returned to Nigeria when he was about 25. He has been one of the leading figures in Nigerian theatre, writing a number of successful plays and also leading a theatrical company. He is the first African to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature, 1986. His writings are known for their humor and satire. Notice these expressions in the poem and guess their meaning from the context. Rancid breath. Spectroscopic flight of fancy. Rearing on the thunderclap. Peroxide blonde. Raven black. Squelching tar. Brunette. Clinical assent. Understanding the poem. 1. State the central issue in the poem. 2. There are intervals of silence in the interaction between the landlady and the prospective tenant. What are the reasons for this? 3. How is color highlighted in the poem and why? List all the words in the poem that suggest color. 4. Which are the lines in the poem that impressed you the most and why? Page 116. 5. You know what hide and seek is? What would hide and speak mean? 6. Certain words in the poem are in capital letters. Why? 7. Why do you think that the poet has chosen the title Telephone Conversation? If you were to suggest another title for the poem, what would it be? 8. The power of poetry lies in suggestion and understatement. Discuss this with reference to the poem. Try this out. 1. Enact the conversation bits with your partner. 2. Attempt a description of A. The place from which the call was made. B. The lady at the other end. C. The speaker in the poem. 3. The poem evokes a mental picture of the scene. Draw a rough sketch to illustrate the episode. 4. The poem ends with, "Wouldn't you rather see for yourself?" Imagine a personal encounter between the two people in the poem and write down the dialogue they might have had. Suggested reading. 1. Idan Rey and Other Poems, 1967, by Wold Soinka. 2. Poems from Prison, 1969, by Wold Soinka.